This is how I made a smart lab from my own house.
Pardon the interruption, but I believe you may find this quite interesting.
In this video, I'll show you how I upgraded my setup and how you guys can create the perfect makerspace for all of your projects. If you've ever wanted to get into engineering or build robots like me, this video is the perfect place to start building your own setup. And if you're already a maker, feel free to steal some ideas and use this as inspiration for your own lab. Now then, I've broken this video down into the core parts of building a great makerspace at home, so you can focus on what really matters. This video covers everything from the desk to the holographic display. So let's not waste any time. I build all of my projects from home, but as the scale of my work grew, I ran into a pretty major problem with my old setup. Specifically the desk. The problem is, it's small. So I decided to get a new one. Specifically the E6 standing desk from FlexiSpot. The assembly was straightforward and it fit perfectly into my setup. With the amount of soldering, coding, and editing I do, I really needed to stand more often. My favorite part about this desk though is that it's able to remember your preferences and go to those heights with just the push of a button. As for the rest of my space, I hung up a few records that I thrifted for decorative purposes, please don't get mad at me, and I have my 3D and 2D printer on a shelf nearby. Aside from having enough space, there's a few things every makerspace should have. The first thing I want to mention might be super basic, but it's a cutting mat. Whether I'm soldering, trimming wires, or assembling parts, it protects the desk and gives me a clean, flat surface to work on. I never lose any parts, plus the grid lines are super useful for making quick measurements. Also, you need to get an extension cord or a power strip. I mounted mine to the edge of my desk so that way I'm never more than an arm's reach away from an outlet. Having that easy access makes a bigger difference than you'd think. No crawling under the desk, no unplugging stuff just to swap a cable, it's all right there. Now for the most important part of an electronics lab, you need to have good lighting. Especially when you're working with fine electronics, small components, or assembling robots, I've learned that good lighting is not optional. So I upgraded my setup with this machine light from JLCMC, and honestly, it really changed everything. I really recommend getting something stronger than just a lamp for your desk setup. Back to JLCMC, they actually made this whole video possible, and I can't think of a better sponsor for this video because they make a ton of solid mechanical components, and they're way more affordable on their official website compared to retail platforms. Right now they've actually got a deal for you guys where you get $70 worth of coupons if you register for their campaign. Because they integrate their own production line, they can offer competitive prices without sacrificing quality. So if you're setting up your own smart lab, make sure to check out their catalog, I'll leave a link in the description. The last thing I'd recommend is to get a little soldering station for your desk and arms to hold the wires. Or if you're like me, you can build a robot to do that. Now let's talk about something that's just as important as the tools. Motivation. I think it's important to keep something on your desk that inspires you. For me, that's this replica of Tony Stark's arc reactor. I've always been curious about exploring and science, but the Iron Man movies are what first got me into mechatronics engineering in the first place. On the other side of that shelf, I also have another project of mine. That's the Flex Hand, a robotic hand I created that's able to detect and mimic your movements in real time. It's one of my proudest projects and a reminder that no matter where you start, your ideas can take you places. This project led me to many expos and fairs, and recently I was selected to represent my country at a Global Innovation Expo. So keeping a project or an achievement on your desk is a good way to keep you motivated as well. The last thing I'd recommend adding is giving yourself a reason to go outside. I take my notebook with me whenever I go for walks or spend time in nature, and it's how I collect ideas when I'm away from the screen so that I can later bring them back to the lab and make them a reality. Because at the end of the day, it isn't just about having the right tools at your desk, it's about building a space where your ideas can come to life. And sometimes when I really need to focus without tech, I'll just pop in a record instead of listening to Spotify. It gives my workspace another atmosphere. Unless you want to lean into the futuristic look.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am JARVIS, a virtual artificial intelligence.
Created using a mix of Python, Gemini, and GPT, I created JARVIS. My very own personalized AI. To make him a real part of my setup, I installed a short-throw projector that brings JARVIS to life right here on my wall. Like a real holographic display. I built this entire heads-up display myself, and I even included some hand-tracking technology from my Flex project, so let's break it down. In the bottom left corner, it displays the current track you're listening to. At the top, you've got the precise time and calendar date. On the left, you've got a to-do list you can update and an icon that displays the time of day. And on the bottom right is space that I can use for holographic displays of all my projects. Turning my old projects into holographic animations was honestly a lot of fun, and I think I'm gonna keep doing it for all my projects moving forward. So you might catch an old project of mine floating around on my wall. I can also move it by grabbing it with my hand in front of my MacBook camera. While I'm still improving JARVIS every day, this heads-up display and the code for it is completely free and open source, and you can find it on my Arc page. Arc is basically a social media platform, but for inventors and creators. Think of it like an Instagram, but for engineers. So whether or not you're just starting out or creating advanced robots, Arc is designed to inspire and empower the next generation of makers, and you'll find me on there too. So if you want to download this code or shoot me a message, you can do so on Arc for free, you can always send me an email, or you can join the new MateoTechLab Discord server, where I'm looking for people who are passionate about building projects to come and join me. This last part is probably the easiest, but also the most important. Personality. It's where you add the things that make you happy. This could be a Lego set you've always loved, a small gift from someone important, or just something that makes the space feel like yours. There's no right or wrong, and it's your chance to make your setup unique to you. Because when your space reflects who you are, working here doesn't just feel productive, it feels like home. So while this wasn't my typical video where I explain a science concept or break down a project, I hope you still learned something. Specifically, that you don't need to have a multi-million dollar setup to be an engineer. So with all that said, stay curious, keep building, and don't forget to subscribe.